Hamilton start of his 11-year career. He'll be opposed by 42-year-old Dwayne Rollison, who was such a stalwart for this team as it almost reached the Stanley Cup Finals last year, right through the playoffs. He's looking to get going on a roll here in a new season. With the puck for the Lightning, it's Brett Clark dropping it off for Steve Downey. His shot is deflected away. David Clarkson trying to clear that zone. Clarkson a goal and an assist in that 4-2 win over the Lightning 23 days ago here in Tampa for the Devils. Peter Sikora on left wing. Puck is shot in by Matt Termina. As it comes back of the point, there's a shot, a save by Rollison. Rebound, they score! Peter Sikora picked up the rebound as Rollison made the save on the shot by Bryce Salvador. And Sikora pounces on that puck at the 28-second mark.
Rick, this is unacceptable rebound control by Dwayne Rollison. It's a simple shot. There's no traffic there. He just puts that right out in front to Peter Sikora, and he finishes on the back end. That's a routine save. I mean, that's not a hard save. It's a quick shot on goal, obviously, by Bryce Salvador. But when you spit out rebounds like that, the Toyota RoboCam will show you how easy it is for Peter Sikora. I mean, that's just not good enough. That is the wrong way for Tampa Bay to start.
They have been bitten by some bad starts on the road, but generally have started pretty well at home. But not a good start here at the 28-second mark. Sikora scoring for the Devils, his sixth goal of the season back in the NHL this season after playing in the Czech Pro League and the KHL last year. As the puck is shot in by Nate Thompson, Henrik Tillander back. He's checked by Adam Hall. Zach Parise couldn't get it out. The shot by Eric Brewer is off the back of the net. Puck chopped to Ilya Kovalchuk, rolled away to Victor Hedman. He fanned on his shot attempt, and the pass out for Parise. These two units should see a lot of each other tonight. Hedman and Brewer, the matchup pair on defense. And Hall, Thompson, and Dana Tyrell expected to see action against that Kovalchuk-Parise and Adam Henrique line that Pierre spoke of in the open that's been so effective. Salvador and Eliach got the assists on the goal by Sikora at 28 seconds. Steven Stamkos forced behind the net by Alexander Urbom. Youngster just called up from Albany in the American Hockey League. And back for the puck, Pavel Kabina, who has returned to the lineup tonight. Let's take a look at the stats for our starting goaltenders presented by Honda Pilot. And we look at the comparison there. Hedberg has been enjoying a fine season. Marty Brodeur has been trying to find his game consistently. He's been pulled in two of his last four games, expected to see action against the Panthers tomorrow night in South Florida in a back-to-back situation.
And you know how hard that back-to-back is, Rick. It's a very difficult back-to-back, especially for the northern-based teams.
And Rollison has been watching Matthew Garon quite a bit lately. Garon has played in eight of the last 10.
What a show he put on in New York when the Tampa Bay Lightning came from behind to beat the Rangers. Garon was exceptional.
Puck worked in on goal by Tim Sestito and covered by Rollison. It'll be interesting, Pierre, to see if this puts the Lightning on their heels with this early goal by New Jersey.
And New Jersey, this is where they're different under Peter DeBoer. A lot of stretch passes. You see Matthias Tenby working hard on Matt Gilroy right there. Good play by Gilroy. And under Pete DeBoer, he's done a great job implementing a new ideology to these New Jersey Devil players. And I can tell you, Rick, having visited with these players, they're having a ton of fun playing it.
Yeah, their strategy with a 1-0 lead early in a hockey game would have been a little different than what it is now, huh?
Yeah, a lot different. And this is the other thing they're doing. They get four lines engaged, and they really lean on you. Every line understands their role. This puck should be deep from Bolden, and then they can engage the forecheck.
Their fourth line was critical in holding off the Lightning in that earlier meeting. As we pointed out, they had the 3-0 lead. The Lightning started out the third with the first eight shots, closed within 3-2, but that fourth line had a couple of good puck possession shifts, and that seemed to quiet things down, and the Devils went on to the 4-2 win. Here's Dominic Moore shooting. Saved by Hedberg. He'll hang on. Let's go inside the glass, presented by Verizon with Pierre.
Well, it's never boring endanger the National Hockey League. And for the New Jersey Devils, they got a former Tampa Bay Lightning player in Curtis Foster just before the game started. Keith Jones talked about it. So you look at what Curtis Foster comes over from Anaheim with Timo Pielmeier, depth goaltender for Rod Pelly and Mark Frazier. Biggest thing he does, he brings power play presence. Adam Oates was an assistant coach here in Tampa. Keith Jones nailed it. And Adam Oates is an important part of the New Jersey Devils coaching staff.
Pavel Kabina's shot just missed the net. He's missed the last four games because of a lower body injury. The puck cleared out by Sikora and the Devils. Kabina in a race. His recovery from that injury being tested here by David Clarkson. Finds him in front. Rollison, a great stop on Eliash. From the point, Adam Larson, the outstanding young defenseman, missing the net with a shot. Steve Downey back to Vinny LeCavalier. Cuts it across the line against Larson. Hooks it on goal. Hedberg the save. And he finds that loose puck before Tom Pyatt.
Well, we talked about the aggressive nature of the New Jersey Devils, Rick, and you're going to see it. David Clarkson on Pavel Kabina. He wins the race, pulls away, separates himself. Nice cross-ice feed right onto Patrick Eliash's stick. And a nice save by Dwayne Rollson. At the other end, Vinny LeCavalier tries to go out front for Steve Downey. And Moose Hedberg won't let it go across the crease.
Here, do you think Clarkson gets the credit he deserves for the things that he can do for this team? He's known as just primarily a physical player.
David Clarkson is a real special player. His last 3 years, 17 goals, 11 goals, and 12 goals. Let's see who's going to get this penalty. I think it's Eric Brewer. And this is because of a foot race won by Zach Parise. Another example of what the New Jersey Devils are about. Zach Parise wins what should have been an icing. He wins a race, and then you get engaged in a one-on-one with Eric Brewer. You see the free hand come right into the chest of Parise, put him down, and that's why Brewer goes to the box. But all that was because of a one race by Zach Parise.
Now Brewer off for the hold, and the Devils embark on the first power play of the game. This power play brought to you by Gander Mountain. Devils on the season, only 12.6%, tied for 26th, and thus the acquisition of Curtis Foster from the Anaheim Ducks. Kovalchuk at the point, working with Mark Fain, sliding it down low to Clarkson. Fain rushing to get there. Nate Thompson tapped it by him and out to center, and Kovalchuk backing up the play. Kovalchuk in a slow start, two goals in his first 11, but he's heated up lately with four in his last six as part of that line with Parise and Henrique. As Eliash stick handled through traffic. Here's the shot by Fain, saved by Rollison. He covers that puck and he'll get a stoppage with 1:26 to go in the penalty.
It's good movement by the Devils. Kovalchuk to Fain, and then a little screen play and a chip by Zach Parise, and a nice save by Dwayne Rollison. Two in a row right now after a shaky start. Rollison does a nice job tracking the puck. Entry by Eliash. Kovalchuk, little saucer pass. Fain will shoot it on goal, and then the deflection by Parise. No second chance opportunity for Clarkson. A job well done by Rollison, much better than its initial save opportunity.
Now Clarkson gets tossed out of the draw, and it will be Eliash, who's been playing mostly center the past couple of years. Faceoff win by Tampa Bay. It's cleared out by Victor Hedman. Lightning on the kill, 82% even, 18th best in the NHL rankings. Long lead pass reaching Eliash, dropping it back. Parise to the point to Fain. Kovalchuk watched by Pyatt. They got Parise right around the net. The backdoor play to Eliash. The pass got away from him. He's checked by Hedman. Moore clears it out. Tampa Bay will get a change.
Oh, that's a nice job by Dominic Moore and Tommy Pyatt. Good stick positioning.
Puck off the glass support, and an alert. Rollison was there to keep it behind the net. And now the puck is cleared out of play, deflected, as it was indicated by referee Rob Martel.
And Adam Oates is the architect of the power play here in New Jersey. They're 26th in the league right now. He knows Curtis Foster. Keith Jones was talking about it with Liam and Mike Milbury before the game started. He'll make a difference now for Ilya Kovalchuk, having the right-handed shooting Foster, who's 6'5", 230 pounds. He comes from Carp, Ontario, where Larry Robinson's from, Rick, right next door.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Well, the Lightning come up with a puck, and Clark trying to clear it out. Play forced back to the Devil's zone. Foster, well known in this building. Adam Oates on the coaching staff here a couple of years ago for Rick Tocchet, and Foster was a primary component on the power play for Tampa Bay. And I could tell you one thing is the rink people They could probably tell you exactly how many panes of glass he broke with that tremendous shot he has. I would say it double figures.
This is a great acquisition for New Jersey.
Here's a shot by Termine. That's deflected in. A power play goal late in the opportunity for the Devils, and New Jersey has a 2-0 lead.
Well, I've already seen some good movement by New Jersey, forcing Dwayne Rolison and some good saves. This is the second power play group. Sikora, good patience. Get it up high. Get bodies to the net. Simplify things. Dinas Zubris with a little chip, and he fools it. It's a good release by Matt Termina. And you see that chip right there by Dinas Zubris past Dwayne Rolison. 2-0 New Jersey, and this is not the start that Tampa Bay wanted, especially on home ice.
Well, Zubris with his 9th goal of the season, and Termina with his first point since coming back from Albany. He and Urban, recent call-ups, injuries on that Devil defense, including Anton Volchenkov, who's out with a hand injury for this game. In fact, not on the trip for their second game against the Panthers in Sunrise, Florida tomorrow. Pass through the legs of Ryan Carter. Carter gets to it. He's checked by Marc-Andre Bergeron. Puck loose behind the net. Nick Palmieri on it. Palmieri fires, and it's stopped by Rolison. Deflected behind the net. Bergeron with it. Out for Stamkos. Closely covered by Palmieri. And Bergeron takes it. Both teams making some changes. The pass. Malone let it go with Downey on the rush with him. Here, what does Tampa Bay have to do to start generating something here?
Win some races, start getting physical, get somebody to get like LeCavalier did in New York. Start getting angry. These guys are too soft right now. There's another race won by Clarkson.
Well, you certainly are right on it in terms of generating that anger against the Rangers. The first game without St. Louis, they were kind of stunned in the morning because that accident with St. Louis taking the shot in the face and fracturing facial and nasal bones happened at the morning skate, so they were all kind of stunned. And that incident with Artem Anisimov really kind of turned that game around a little bit, but they haven't been able to carry over that fire, it seems. Matt Gilroy with a pass for Teddy Purcell. It's played back by Fain into the Lightning zone. Zubris scores his 198th career goal. Termina and Adam Henrique on the assist for the Devils, and their 2-0 lead, that goal at 5:38. Kovalchuk with it. Moore had it slotted away by Termina. Gilroy fires it off the glass, and Termina back for it. Chased in there by Moore. Stamkos on the scene as well with Blair Jones, a recent call-up with the injury to St. Louis. That took place on Thursday. Palmieri gets it out. Lead pass for Parise, escorted by Gilroy. Parise's pass in the skates of Kovalchuk. Gilroy gets it back. Ryan Carter in position to take it. Bergeron handing it now to Moore. Work free, Gilroy with it. 2-0 Devils, they've got a 7-2 shot advantage. 11 and a half minutes to go in this opening period. Jalinder, his try is blocked by Thompson. And it's Zubris down the boards. Controlled by Bergeron, he finds Thompson. It's held in by Palmieri, deflected by Carter just over the net. He's bumped by Kabina.
They need a TV timeout here pretty quick because right now Tampa Bay has to wake up. They are sleepwalking right now.
Now they'll get one here, 11-10 remaining in this first period. It only took 28 seconds for Peter Sikora to open the scoring, and then late in a power play opportunity, Zubas made it to Lightning coaches Guy Boucher in the left and Marty Ramon discuss how to dig themselves out of a 2-0 hole here. Here the Devils have to love this first period start. They'd only scored 16 goals in the first period coming in.
Energy will help Tampa Bay a lot. Maybe that's why they have these guys on the ice right now. Pyatt, Thompson, and Tyrell, they'll bring energy. There's an example of energy. Again, Thompson wins a race. This is what they have to have, more guys winning races.
And Boucher switching up some combinations right off the bat here with Pyatt joining Tyrell and Thompson. A wide open man in front. Great save, Rolison there on David Clarkson. It's clear down the ice. We'll get an icing call, but Rolison making a huge stop there.
David Clarkson's not happy with himself because he stopped the puck. He got that puck and he should have released it in one motion. Peter Sikora, Patrick Elias, happy with the way they moved the puck. You see him get it and he holds on just a split second, and he knows it's not an easy play for a right-hand shot there. If he's a left-hander, it's an easier one-timer, but Clarkson was shaking his head coming off the ice. But this line found some early chemistry. Elias, Sikora, and Clarkson.
Kovalchuk with a quick release, but it was blocked. Henrique, 21-year-old, checked there by Hedman, who will turn 21 this weekend. Dana Tyrell to center, bumped there by Fain. Kovalchuk winds it up. Swings around Downey, forced to dump it in. Parise getting to it. And slipping in front, Henrique. Puck left in the slot, swatted away by Bergeron, and Downey marches out with it. Trying to get it behind the Devil defense. Downey with it. And it worked free by Parise with his persistent checking. Downey hangs in there. Two number nines going at it pretty hard. And away comes Kovalchuk for the Devils. Roldison takes a look. He sees he's got Ryan Shannon on the wing. Shannon with a goal and an assist when these teams met back on November the 19th. His first goal with the Lightning. Bergeron. Off the glass. Malone well covered. Germina fell down, but it's time to get back to his skates. He'll start it ahead to Clarkson. Kept wide by Gilroy. Gabina steps into him. Clarkson trying to center. Deflected by Purcell. Clarkson gets it back. And a swing away from Gabina. Look for Eliash out in front. Stamkos scrambles back to take it for the Lightning. And he races out to center ice. Taking on Salvador, swinging around him. Salvador reaching with a stick to poke the puck away.
Well, that's more of that energy that Tampa has to have, Rick. That's a good job by Steven Stamkos. Try to put some pressure on the Devils' defense and also on Hedberg.
With the puck, it's Matthias Tedby out in front. Deflected by Sestito on goal. A save by Rollison. And he'll hang on. As the Devils continue with a 2-0 lead, we'll hear from Guy Boucher next.
Well, first of all, we can't let those late men come in. Right now, we're mesmerized by the puck on the back check. They're catching us with their late men. So we got to take care of that. Right, they get momentum off of that.
Dwayne Rollison didn't have a great first attempt on a save, obviously, the first goal. How long a leash does he have tonight?
Well, I mean, we're trying to win, so obviously we'll see what happens next. I still believe we can score a goal, get some momentum. He's going to get some more confidence off of that. We'll progress from there.
Thanks, Keith.
Thank you.
Thanks, Pierre. Kia Motors presents our coach interview with Guy Boucher, and we saw the numbers recently for Dwayne Rollison as he's tried to build the level of confidence he had when he really was such a huge part of the success of this team, getting 103 points last year and coming to within one game of reaching the Stanley Cup Finals. He makes a save on Larson here and holds for the whistle.
Rick, and this is what we talk about when we battle ready. Face-off situation, kick it out, muscle at the point of attack there if you're Blair Jones. You lose the battle, and then it's a tough save opportunity for Rollison. Win one-on-one battles. It's that simple. And Eric Bolton just didn't let Blair Jones win that face-off situation.
Hall called in to oppose Sestito on this one. And Hall pulls it back. Clark trying to shake free of Tedenby. Blair Jones waiting in right wing with a point. It's Tillander with a shot. It's missed the net as Bolton tried to get a piece of it. At center, it's Larson. And Tillander, the longtime Sabre, driving it in. Clark under check, helped out by Jones. Away comes Moore. Hall steams into that corner with Tillander. Down he goes. And Tedenby involved. The puck underneath the veteran defenseman Tillander as Hall trying to pry it loose. Larson muscled his way in there for it. Larson as Zubras turning at center. Nate Thompson right on him. Palmieri protects the puck. He'll drive it to the corner. Rollison flips that stick over to play it. Pressured by Carter, got it loose. And out for Pyatt, gave it up to Zubras. Bergeron back for Tampa Bay. Lugs it in, and the play is whistled out offside. For 36 hours, step inside the life of NHL superstar Patrick Kane. It's the premiere of an all-new series, NHL 36, featuring Patrick Kane, Wednesday at 6:30 Eastern, followed by his Blackhawks and the Minnesota Wild here on Versus.
Patrick Kane is bringing it right now, playing on a line with Jonathan Toews. They're thriving. The Chicago Blackhawks are having some success. Huge win against San Jose last night. Patrick Sharp with the winner, but Patrick Kane, electrifying one-on-one player. And he's not shy away from the rink either, Rick.
And it'll be a very interesting show to see his life away from the rink as he gets ready for a game. Here's a save by Hedberg, having to come up with a super stop on Thompson to keep it a 2-0 Devils lead. Edmund back up the boards. From the point, Urban with a shot. He dribbled it wide. Brewer after it. Sakura plays it back behind the net for his longtime buddy Patrick Elias, who's checked there by Hedman. Stamkos takes it. Fans on the pass. Devils back on side. And they'll go for a change. Parise wins the puck along the boards. Downey comes back for Tampa Bay. From center, he'll play it in on Hedberg. Reinforcements coming late for the bench. Malone getting in there. The Devils move it out with Parise. His pass deflects back to Henrique. Dropping it off for Kovalchuk. In range to shoot. Couldn't get it through. Clark working with Gilroy. LeCavalier positioned on the boards. Devils leading on the goals by Sikora and Zubras. Ryan Malone centers in front, and Hedberg alert with that goal stick. Tap the pass away. Kovalchuk winds his way to center ice. And we get Parise dropping that puck at the line. The play's offside. 2-0 New Jersey. Let's take a look at our Coors Light cold hard facts. Last three seasons, most goals, Steven Stamkos at the head of the class by a pretty wide margin, Pierre. In a 51-goal season where he and Sidney Crosby tied for the Rocket Richard Trophy, was way out in front for the first 4 months of last year in goal scoring, and Corey Perry had just a tremendous finish to end up with the award last year, and Stamkos 45 goals. Stamkos leans in against Carter. Bergeron finds Nate Thompson. Little chip in charge for Pyatt, backhanding it toward Hedberg, and he'll calmly hang on to it.
What the New Jersey Devils have done so well tonight compared to Tampa, win races. You see Zach Parise winning a race, it leads to a penalty to Eric Brewer. That should have been an icing. Here's Cabina losing a foot race to David Clarkson. Here's another foot race, Ryan Carter winning against Bergeron. Tampa Bay's defense is too slow right now. They got to start winning some races because the New Jersey Devils roll four lines. They're going to attack this undermanned Tampa defense, and they're going to force the goaltender into too many save opportunities.
Well, Stamkos wins this draw to Brewer. Sliding it toward Tom Pyatt. Out battles Henrique, however, Kovalchuk was there to curl it back to center. Here, what do you see out of Kovalchuk moving to right wing now? That appears to be where they want to use him full time.
He had a long talk with Pete DeBoer and also Adam Oates, and Adam Oates had a long talk with him saying, hey, listen, I played with Brett Hull and Cam Neely, and they were real good players for me, and I was a right-handed center, and it really worked out, and you're playing with two really good players in Parise and Henrique, and it's going to work out for you too. And he's buying in, and I think that's really helped Ilya Kovalchuk and the New Jersey Devils.
8 goals so far this season, not where we've become accustomed to seeing him. Last year, 31 in his first full season with the Devils. But as we mentioned, 4 in the last 6 games, so he's starting to come on to help that line provide offense. Dominic Moore for Tampa Bay, out to the point. Gilroy shooting, deflected by Dana Tyrell, just wide as Ryan Shannon was in front, occupying Termina. Moore trying to get it behind the defense, knocked down by Salvador. Moore bumping there with Termina. Blair Jones arrives.
Much better job by Tampa right now. Now they're starting to initiate win races.
Gilroy drives it right back in. 4:12 to go in this opening period. The shot's 10-4 New Jersey. Sikora gets the lead pass. Clarkson checked by Brewer. Adam Hall on right wing sends it off to Linder, and it comes back to Hedberg. He keeps it away from Speedy Tyrell with a Jones shooting, a save by Hedberg. There's an example there, Pierre. The speed of Tyrell is usually a factor in every game.
Well, he's got great speed, and he understands what got him to the NHL and what's going to keep him in the NHL. Hard work.
Hedberg keeps this one on the boards. Hall there, throwing it in front, knocked down. A good play by Bolton, and he is set down on the hit by Adam Hall.
You can see the last two or three minutes, Rick, Tampa Bay's really woken up, and that's a positive thing for them. Now they just have to find ways to get more second and third chance opportunities.
Well, they dug themselves a 3-0 hole the last time the Devils were here, but that was all in the second period. Didn't leave them much time to come back. Now 2-0 in this contest. They've got more time to work their way back into it, but still have yet to beat Hedberg so far in this game. The puck turned over. It's taken by Fain. Scuffed the shot. Backhands it into traffic. And Kabina comes away with it. Moves it to Bergeron.
Boy, the Devils are really utilizing an entire bench here tonight so far because of the 2-0 lead. That allows Peter DeBoer to keep his guys fresh.
See a player like Nick Palmieri, who since he's come back up has played about 5 minutes, maybe even less, scored their goal the other night, or the other afternoon, in a 2-1 loss to Montreal. Here's Gilroy out in front. Quick shot. They score! Steve Downey gets Tampa Bay on the board. It's a 2-1 hockey game.
You could see they were starting to get it back. And this is all Steven Stamkos all the time. The big bodies are out front. Ryan Malone crashing in the net. But this is a great job by 91 in blue. He's just so aware, working in a one-on-one against Palmieri, buys some time, and then Gilroy, nice cross-ice feed into the wingspan. You see the real speed time for Steven Stamkos, giving it up to Gilroy, put it in a nice shooting position for Downey, and he just blows it right by Hedberg with a little help from Ryan Malone down low in front, causing some havoc. That's how to reel it in if you're Tampa, much better, but you can see it, Rick, the last two or three minutes they started a push.
Well, Downey's one of those players whom they're counting on. He had 20 goals a couple of years ago, 10 last year, but has the capability of helping out with secondary scoring. He scores his fourth goal on the season and third in the last couple of weeks. So he's been starting to come on. Kovalchuk into Parise. Works against Brewer. Enrique in tight. Reek back to the point, the shot by Salvador, and it's gobbled up by Rolison. He'll hang on with a minute 50 to go in the period.
That's a good way to stabilize some things, too. Get a save from your goaltender. It's a cycle situation for the top line of the Devils. Parise, Kovalchuk, and Henrique. And then a point shot coming in from Bryce Salvador, but no rebound by Dwayne Rolison. But Stamkos, that was all him all the time. You could just see how elusive and electrifying he can be, not just as a scorer, but as a playmaker as well.
But the comments that Guy Boucher made this morning, specifically talking about the power play, he said, without St. Louis, we've got guys who specialize in shooting the puck. Here's Malone shooting, kicked out by Hedberg. Stamkos with it. He was saying that LeCavalier is a shooter. Malone's a shooter. They need Stamkos to become more of a facilitator, and he certainly was in an even strength situation there. Gilroy at the point, fires, and it's blocked by Sikora. Out for Clarkson. Devils will go for a change. As Palmieri comes on, I was making the point before the goal that it seems like he's seeing more action in this first period than he has in recent games. Here's Jones, he scores! Blair Jones swings around the Devil defense. He has tied this game up.
Tons of speed through the neutral zone. Stretch pass out of their own zone. Gilroy with a seeing eye pass, little chip play, and Blair Jones right around Urbom, and he finishes around Hedberg. That's just a well-constructed play by the Tampa Bay Lightning. Nice chip play by Dana Tyrell right into the skating of Blair Jones, and he finishes it off with good puck possession skills around Urbom.
Now Jones scores his first goal in 13 games with the Lightning this season. He's been back and forth with the Norfolk Admirals of the American Hockey League, and he scores his third career goal in 69 games to tie the game at two. Lecallier's back in, intended to be a pass for Stamkos. A collision behind Hedberg dislodges the net with 57.4 seconds.
Well, Blair remaining. Jones has a unique story, Rick, coming up from Binghamton in the American Hockey League while he was with Norfolk. He gets called up because of the injury to Martin St. Louis. So instead of getting in an airplane, he can't do that. Instead of getting in a limousine, there is none. He gets in a taxi cab, Rick. Take it away. What happens?
Well, the cab driver, when Jones said, we need to get to Madison Square Garden in New York, says, you mind if I bring my wife along? And so they pick her up. And as Jones tells the story, they're playing country music pretty loud. He says, I couldn't even listen to my music on my earphones. So they finally get to Madison Square Garden $550 later. That was the fare. And he arrives just in time, gets a sub sandwich for a pregame meal, and steps into the lineup for the injured Marty St. Louis. Kovalchuk back for the Devils. Feeding it through. Termina joining the attack. His shot is deflected by Stamkos. Tyrell and Gilroy get the assists on the goal by Jones. Gilroy and Stamkos on the Downey goal. So Matt Gilroy, a couple of nifty setups as Tampa Bay has scored twice in a minute 20 to tie the game up. Wraparound by Moore. Stopped by Hedberg, and he'll hang on to it with 9 seconds to go in the period.
I don't know what Guy Boucher said during one of the TV timeouts, but his team is clearly bought in. Much more speed, much more determination. And Dominic Moore, who was a hero in New York the other night, goes right around Matt Terramina and then forces Johan Hedberg into a good save. And for Dominic Moore, tying goal for Boucher in New York, game-winning goal in the shootout. And for Boucher, he's an emotional guy, and he's trying to get this team to start buying into the emotion that he has.
Patrick Elias on this faceoff, pulling it back to Mark Fane. Fane takes his time in no particular hurry in the closing seconds of period number one, with a score tied at two. Well, stay tuned for the first intermission as Liam McHugh, Mike Milbury, Keith Jones will be talking about the update on the health of Sidney Crosby of the Penguins and the coaching change that took place earlier today in Los Angeles with the Kings. Well, the Devils jump in front on goals by Sikora, the 28-second mark, and Zubras in a power play deflection. Downey and Jones answer for Tampa Bay just a minute and 20 seconds apart. We're tied at two. The faceoff to begin play in the second period. The shots 11-10 Devils as they ended up. They started out 10-2 New Jersey, and Tampa Bay came out with eight of the last nine shots to end the period. As Peter Sikora, who started the scoring in the first 30 seconds of the game, long pass out for Clarkson. Patrick Elias coming up with it. Tillander will send it off the boards, back through center, batted away by Gilroy. Off to a strong start for the Lightning with a pair of assists. Elias will chip it down the boards.
Former Hobie Baker winner, Boston University, Matt Gilroy. Final Four is going to be here, huh, Rick, this spring?
That's right. Coming up the first full weekend of April. Here's a shot by Gilroy, a save by Hedberg. Rebound comes down for Tillander.
Well, you heard Mike and Keith talk about both goaltenders not being overly sharp in the first period. There's another example. That's a routine save opportunity, and it turns into a juicy rebound. Not good enough.
As the Devils work toward the net, it's jammed home by Parise. As he and Henrique worked in behind the net, snuck out in front, and Zach Parise has given the Devils the lead back again at 3-2.
This is a strange goal. Just when you think Tampa Bay has it coming back, you can see the reaction from Guy Boucher. But it's a New Jersey Devils getting pucks in deep and winning races. There's a one race, chip it down to Henrique, and then Zach Parise. I can't believe Rolson's that soft on the bowl right there. That's a routine save again. This isn't a lot of second or third chance opportunity. I understand Gilroy's got to be harder, but Dwayne Rolson's got to be a ton harder there.
Well, Parise and Henrique both had lengthy point streaks ended by the Canadiens at a 2-1 loss to Montreal over the weekend. We've got a delay with the clock.
Oh, we got a goalie. No, we got a goalie change. This is what I was asking Boucher. That's unacceptable from Rolson. That's just not good enough, and that's why he's getting pulled. And I can understand Boucher. You heard what he said to me in the first period, Rick. We're in this game to win it, and you can't win with goaltending like that.
Now Rolison, as with the clock malfunctioning, we still don't know exactly when that goal was scored here earlier in the second period, but you look at the record for Mathieu Garon, who has seen action in 8 of the last 10 games and has played pretty steadily for Guy Boucher in that span of time. Parise scoring at the 56-second mark, we're told. So Rolison facing 12 shots and allowing 3 goals in a little over 20 minutes. But Parise so dangerous around the net. It's just amazing, Pierre, that a guy who's 5'11", 190 pounds like that could be so effective in the trenches. But he's certainly one of the best in the league in that area.
Great balance, great two-step acceleration. He's just getting some tape alterations to his stick. His dad turned 70 yesterday, J.P. Parise. Happy belated birthday, J.P.
We'll second that one. Former terrific Islander and Minnesota North Star player in his career. Vinny LeCavalier with a puck for Tampa Bay, working with Downey and Malone. The pass in front was deflected away by Parise in the right spot defensively. He gets the pass from Henrique. Down that left side shooting. Garon makes the save. He comes out to cover, facing that first shot in taking over for Rolison.
Rick, we talked about this line, and this is a first save opportunity for Mathieu Garon. Watch how quickly they move the puck. Kovalchuk to Henrique, and look where Parise is coming from. Henrique buys a little time, moving to his right, and that allows Parise to step into his pass, skate wide on Eric Brewer. That little move right there allows Parise to catch up. He snaps it on goal. Look at his head. He's identifying the target. That's why you just asked me about Parise. There's an example of why he's able to score as a smaller man in the league. So smart.
And he's meshed so well with the young centerman, Henrique. And the Devils really excited about getting Travis Zajac in the lineup finally, perhaps by this weekend. He ruptured an Achilles tendon training back in August and has missed all the games until this point. And he's been a steady performer in 5 years for this team. So with Henrique's emergence and Zajac coming back, things looking up for the Devils up the middle.
The only way Zajac's not back on Friday night when the Devils host Dallas is if he has a setback. That's the target Friday night.
Gabina with a shot deflected wide. Jones, who bumped into Hedberg, comes up with a puck. Jones's goal tied the game at 2 late in the first for Tampa Bay. Bergeron's drive was blocked there by Termina. Hall has it, backhands it in front, and Hedberg with a save on Tyrell, who dove in front of the net to get that on goal. Hedberg was still looking over his left shoulder.
Well, Mike Milbury wanted to see Hedberg a little bit more aggressive with his stick. That's what saved the goal right there. Aggressive stick play by Johan Hedberg.
Larson from center drives it in. Four checks by Eric Bolton, who's faced the Tampa Bay franchise for years as a member of the Atlanta Thrashers, signed with the Devils last summer as a free agent. Talinder wrists it in. Garon, out of Bergeron, he called for it. You could hear him for the ice level mics, but Sestito by that time slipped in to steal the pass. It's work side of the goal, Sestito with it. Recently called up from Albany in the American League. Finds Sikora firing and a save by Garon. He'll hang on to it.
That was Sikora coming off the bench, so he got lost in coverage. And you see Johan Hedberg at the other end of the ice force on the Toyota RoboCam to come up with a big save on the wraparound right there. And then the aggressive stick play right there to bat it away from Blair Jones. So Mike Milbury called for it and he got it. And here's the line change and here's the other side of it. You can see, watch a stick come right out there so Blair Jones can't get it. But the reason why Sikora had a great chance against Garon is because he came off the bench on a change.
Stamkos for Tampa Bay with Thompson and Piatt on the wings. A misconnections on the pass, it results in an icing call.
Rick, we were talking about Friday night. There's Adam Oates, Peter DeBoer, the head coach. On Friday night, the Devils are hosting the Dallas Stars, and they've only retired two numbers in New Jersey, Scotty Stevens and Ken Danico. They're going to do a third, Scotty Niedermeyer, on Friday night. What an amazing celebration of greatness. Scotty Niedermeyer, a four-time Stanley Cup winner, Norris Trophy winner, Team Canada Olympian and gold medal winner. I mean, just a spectacular player. Hall of Famer for sure.
What hasn't he won?
He's won everything. World Junior, World Championship, Stanley Cup. He's won everything.
I don't know if there's another person in the history of sports that has won as many championships at all those levels as Scott Niedermeyer. That should be quite a night. Puck swept in. Brewer gets it for Tampa Bay. Couldn't get it by Clarkson. He's checked by Hedman.
Speaking of celebrations, Rick, by the way, how about our Doc Emmerich going
into
the U.S. Hockey Hall of Fame tonight? Way to go, Doctor.
Absolutely. Just a well-deserved honor for Mike Emmerich. Of course, the longtime voice of the National Hockey League here with Versus at NBC. And pass out in front, deflected behind the net. LeCavalier with it. Of course, Flyers chairman Ed Snyder. Gary Suter, Chris Chelios, Keith Tkachuk, great players all being inducted into the U.S. Hockey Hall of Fame tonight.
And here's a class you're alluding to. Doc Emmerich, Ed Snyder, Chris Chelios. What a career Chelios had. Gary Suter, remember him in Calgary, really in the prime of his career with Al MacInnis, and then Keith Tkachuk. Remember seeing Keith Tkachuk play high school hockey in Boston, Rick?
Really?
Getting drafted by the Winnipeg Jets and playing at Boston University and on a line with Tony Amonte and Sean McEachran. What a line that was. It was for Jack Parker and the BU Terriers, just an amazing line. Downey and Bolton are chirping at one another. And you know what? Bolton's not shy. He'll go with Malone, too. Bolton is an equal opportunity fighter, and he understands his role. See Brad Kovacic just talking to him right now. It'll be interesting to see what happens here because Bolton understands. He's just staring Downey right down. Whenever you want to go, I'm ready. Let's go.
Now from the faceoff, comes back in the Devil's zone, and Downey works to come up with it. He finds Bergeron to the point, loads up, big shot saved by Hedberg, and he kicked the rebound by the stick of LeCavalier. We mentioned Bolton knows the Lightning very well, including Downey. Bolton out with an injured hand for the first 14 games of the season. Now as Garon behind the net got spilled, Ryan Carter involved there, and Pavel Kabina's dropping the gloves with him.
This is a size mismatch for Ryan Carter against Kabina. Kabina's about 250 pounds. Carter's about 195. Carter hangs in there. Kabina does what he has to do, though. It's kind of an innocuous hit on Garon, but it looks like it caught him awkwardly.
Now Kabina in his first game back from injury getting involved with Ryan Carter here at 4:43, and a pretty mildly played first period. And Kabina cut there on the right side of his face.
You'll see right here, just come back. That's, you're not trying to hit him. He's trying to make a play on the puck on Bergeron, but then Kabina says, you hit my guy, I'm gonna dance with you, and he does. And Pavel Kabina's missed the last four games, as you said, Rick, but he starts going after Ryan Carter, and Carter hangs in there pretty well against a much bigger man.
They each get 5 minutes for fighting.
And there was no penalty to Carter when he did hit into Gatton, and that's the right call. He wasn't trying to run over Gatton at all, but you can totally understand what Kabina's trying to do as well.
Here, have you noticed since the Lucic Ryan Miller incident that things have kind of escalated with players bumping into goaltenders, or are we just paying more attention to it since that incident?
I think we're paying more attention to it. Outside of 2-2 running into Miller, you don't really don't have a lot of it viciously happening, I don't think. That wasn't a vicious example. That was not a vicious play.
Nope. Certainly not at all, but they get to majors for fighting. Puck chipped ahead by Hall. Bain coming over for it. Challenge there by Jones. Sikora with it. Brewer reaching for the puck, gets it. Hedman rubbed out Clarkson as things have escalated a bit physically in this contest. Bain comes by for the puck, and he's hounded in there by Jones. By Salvador. Now with the Hyatt with a shot knocked down. Jones battling for the rebound. Backhanded on goal by Thompson. A save by Hedberg. He'll hang on. Tampa Bay buzzing in that Devil zone.
Well, the worker bees have gone to work for the Tampa Bay Lightning. Nate Thompson's one of those worker bees. Blair Jones is another one. Tommy Pyatt's another one. They're winning races. They're going after people. They're establishing physical presence. Look at Blair Jones. He's wiping out devils all over the place. Nate Thompson with a backhand. He goes for the rebound. Tommy Pyatt winning the race. And you see the backhand, a little rebound opportunity potentially, but Edgar's a little bit quicker than Nate Thompson. But a nice job by the hard-working Tampa Bay Lightning players.
Stamkos back to the point. Gilroy, a quick shot. It's blocked. Away comes Parise. Kovalchuk with him. Parise to Kovalchuk. He scores! Ilya Kovalchuk, and Parise burst down the ice after blocking a shot. It's 4-2 Devils.
Rick, Tampa Bay does everything right here except Gilroy puts the puck right into Zach Parise. If you lose a faceoff in your own zone, nowhere to go. Stamkos wins a draw, and Parise knows where to go. He gets right in the shooting lane against Gilroy, and then it's a 2-on-0. There's no way Brett Clark can match speed with Ilya Kovalchuk right there, and the unselfish Parise puts it right into the slick-shooting Kovalchuk, and now it's 4-2. It happens that fast. We talked about this line before the start of the game, Rick, and they do it all right. Henrique wins faceoffs, Parise wins races, and Kovalchuk wins shooting contests.
Couple of goals in a little under 5 minutes for New Jersey. And after surrendering that 2-0 first period lead, they busted back in front by the count of 4-2. And we've talked about how both these teams have been stuck right around two goals a game offensively. The Devils scoring more than two for only the third time in the last 10 games. The Lightning have been held at two or fewer in seven straight. And they're right there at two right now. Kovalchuk swings in against Bergeron. Kovalchuk out to Tolliner, sends it across. Parise fires it back. The shot is blocked by Bergeron as Kovalchuk let it go.
And it's a good thing for Tampa that Bergeron was fearless right there, because that was going in the net.
Parise and Kovalchuk each have been averaging a point a game or better in recent action, sparking the Devils in the second period. Big Zubrus, 6'5", 225. Takes that puck into the zone, looking to hook up with Bolton. Played back by Sestito. Brewer trying to shake free.
Remember when New Jersey had the crash line with Randy McKay and Mike Peluso?
Oh, yeah.
Well, this is their version of the crash line right now with Sestito, Bolton, and Zubrus.
Bobby Holik.
Bobby Holik was a centerman there. Won a Stanley Cup for Jacques Lemaire and the New Jersey Devils.
Yep, 1995, a big part of that championship. As Guerin playing that puck off the glass, around for Teddy Purcell. Ahead for Moore, he'll one-hand it into the Devils' zone and take on Urbom, and he's out to race there by Ryan Shannon. Moore protects the puck. Eliash there defensively. Clark trying to create a little shooting room, does, wrists it. However, it's tipped back of the goal. Shannon with it, couldn't pop it in front. Slipping through, Termina couldn't get it out. Clark with a drive that missed it in. Sharp Kerem coming back to Bergeron. It's played away by Clarkson. Angled perfectly for Sikora. He's waiting to see who's coming. And instead will slide it through, hoping to hook up with Eliash.
There's another example of the new Devils. That wouldn't have happened in the old days with the stretch pass to Sikora.
Thompson looking for his man, Pyatt down the middle. He's held off, and Hedberg covers the puck. We get a whistle and a penalty upcoming to the Devils. Parise giving New Jersey a 3-2 lead, and Kovalchuk followed up. It's 4-2 New Jersey. Rookie defenseman Adam Larson of the Devils is assessed an interference penalty at 8:12. This power play brought to you by Geico, the first opportunity for the Tampa Bay Lightning tonight, as all of a sudden they're down once again by two goals. A power play that has scored on only 14.7% of its chances. Trying to find the mark here against the top penalty killing unit in the NHL. Bergeron to the point. Now to LeCavalier, and a power play unit operating without their maestro, Marty St. Louis. Brewer with a shot, he missed the net. It comes back to Bergeron. LeCavalier has Malone down low. Stamkos back door. Here's Malone right to the net, and a save by Hedberg. He spilled, but the puck ends up underneath him. He covers it up. He was separated from his stick. He got bowled over by the traffic, not just Malone, but teammates as well.
Well, Rick, you talked about the New Jersey Devils being the number one penalty kill because they're so aggressive. Watch Talinder. He has to back off and buy some time. So Malone says, you know what? I'm going to work on Bryce Salvador and bulldoze right into the front of the net on Johan Hedberg. And he forces Hedberg into a very athletic save. And it's a good thing that Adam Henrique was there just to chip the puck to Johan Hedberg. But there's an example of why the Devils, it's not just good goaltending. They're super aggressive in all three zones in the penalty kill.
Well, they've surrendered two goals the last 11 times short, and 29 other teams would take that. But that ended a streak of 35 consecutive kills. That's major news around the Devils. They give up a power play goal. As their percentage in the season, 93.4%. Out comes Marc-Andre Bergeron for Tampa Bay into the zone. Ryan Shannon checked by Fane. Teddy Purcell controls. 50 seconds to go on the call against Larson. Purcell now with Shannon in the slot. The shot by Bergeron deflects, and it's right into Hedberg. He'll hang on to it. Downey was set up around the net as well.
And here's another thing. This is what Pete DeBoer has brought to the Devils party. Look at Dina Zubers going behind the opposition net to try to flush out Marc-Andre Bergeron. And he doesn't quit on the track. He keeps tracking, tracking, tracking. And then Bergeron has to distribute to the outside. But that's exactly the difference in the Devils' mindset. It's aggressive all over the ice. Adam Holtz talking to him right there.
Victor Hedman. Working with Clark, the pass deflected. Hedman trying to get it away. Kovalchuk steals, racing in toward the net. It's batted away to the corner by Garon. And Kovalchuk plays it back to his defense.
Ilya Kovalchuk on the penalty kill. That's a penalty. That's going to be a penalty.
Delay of game. It was fired by Termina from inside his own blue line. You usually see that.
New Jersey 32, a minor penalty, delay of game.
Deflected out or shot out from the glass at the other end, behind the opposition goalie.
Look at Kovalchuk flushing out Hedman and Clark, and he just can't get to that loose puck. And here's Termina from inside his own zone. He launches it up and over the glass into the netting, and it doesn't take everybody long to figure that out. So 20 seconds of 5-on-3. The faceoff becomes so important right now for Patrick Elias, Bryce Salvador, and Henrik Talinder. And this is where Le Cavalier can't lose this draw clean. Can't lose a draw clean.
He has Malone and Downey flanking him back of the point. Stamkos and Bergeron, the two big cannons. However, the Devils do get controlled, and Salvador will clear it down the ice.
Guy Boucher's got to be so upset with that. Vinny Le Cavalier has to scramble that draw and put it to the boards.
Stamkos back into the zone, but 5 seconds remaining on the first penalty to Larson. Bergeron winding, firing, blisters it wide. Le Cavalier has it back. Larson back on. The pass to Stamkos off his skates in front. Chipped on goal by Malone. A save by Hedberg. And the puck is deflected into the netting. Four players waiting for that puck to come down. It ends up out of play with a minute and a half to go on the second call.
When you look at how the Devils set up on the faceoff, I know Le Cavalier is a left-hand shot, but he's got to get that puck to the boards. He loses it cleanly, and that allows Salvador from Elias to get the puck up and out of the zone. I would have put Steven Stamkos a right-hand shot there, and all he has to do is bat the puck to the boards so that they can keep it in the zone and then go on the attack. Just subtle little things like that, and Vinny knows better than that. He's got to scramble that draw.
Well, Malone apparently deflected it out of play because the draw came out of the zone. And Tampa Bay re-enters now with Stamkos. Two power play goals this year. Walks in and shoots, and he sends it over the shoulder of Hedberg. It comes off the glass. Le Cavalier surrounded by three Devils. Nice play to Brewer. Malone stationed in front of Johan Hedberg. In the Devil net. Le Cavalier trailed by Zubras. Gets it back for Malone. Eric Brewer on this unit now. Cavalier across for Brewer, settles it down. Back to Bergeron. Le Cavalier, the one-timer, and he sends it over the shoulder of Hedberg off the glass and back up top to Bergeron. Stamkos circles with it. Brewer now heads for the front of the net. The pass through, Le Cavalier fires, and he sends it wide. The puck was on edge.
Look out, here comes Parise.
Ian Zubras down the ice. Dina Zubras with it. He'll ease it in behind the net for Parise, and Zubras going after it. Scrambled around the net. Bergeron with it. 17 seconds left on the penalty to Termina. Pavelier starts it in. Lightning changing behind him. He's got no one to give the puck for the moment. Finally, Clark has it. Kabina, after serving his major with Carter. Carter staring him down at that point. As out of the box comes Termina, and the Devils' top-ranked penalty-killing unit does it. Back-to-back opportunities for Tampa Bay, protecting a 4-2 lead. Downey trying to work it free. And the chase goes to the opposite boards, and Clark is there. Downey with it. Fires toward the net. It's blocked. In the equipment of Carter, shakes it free. Termina will slide it in. Well, certainly a source of pride and confidence for this Devil team, Pierre, is that penalty killing unit, and they came through.
Well, their penalty kills has been so good, and you think about it, Rick, it's about confidence, about aggression, and it's also about buying into a new system.
Clarkson sets up with a shot. Hedman blocked it. Couldn't get it out. He was hampered there by Sikora. Shannon. The pass reaching Jones, but the play is offside. 7:11 to go in the second period. 4-2 New Jersey.
In the game, they sit back. Are these Devils going to sit back?
Well, we're not going to sit back. It's not exactly how we wanted to handle the two-goal lead. We made a couple mistakes, but Tampa's a team that'll make you pay. You know, we've got a couple young defensemen playing tonight, and you get on the wrong side of a couple of these guys and it's in the net. So I thought we rebounded well. I think we've got our composure back here, and we'll be all right.
Thanks, Peter.
Thanks, Peter.
Peter, thanks very much. Good to see Pete DeBoer getting an opportunity right after being let go by the Florida Panthers. He nearly got them in the playoffs his first year. Only a tiebreaker kept the Panthers out of the playoffs 3 years ago. And now behind the Devils bench. Pass in front to Blair Jones. Chipping it toward the net. Stopped by Hedberg. And Palmieri allows him to cover the puck. And we get the stoppage in play. Let's take a look at our Gillette Fusion ProGlide storyline. And we pick up the scoring in this game with Blair Jones capping a comeback of 2 goals in 1:20 for Tampa Bay late in the first period. But in the second, Zach Parise scoring. And less than 5 minutes later, Kovalchuk, you see number 378 of his career. 33 of those have come against the Tampa Bay Lightning.
Henrik Tillander with a penalty, and Rob Martel caught him from the neutral zone. A trip right in the slot. Watch number 7 on Blair Jones. Going to come in, get the stick in there, get the foot in there. Down goes Jones to the box, goes Tillander. Right back to the power play goes Tampa.
This power play brought to you by Verizon 4G as Teddy Purcell across. Here's Kabina looking for Downey. And it deflects away, cleared out by the Devils. That puck is up for grabs. Who's going to get it? Parise and Henrique both there. They score! Adam Henrique converts on the Parise pass. A shorthanded goal for the Devils. And their lead is now 5-2.
Brett Clark again couldn't match pace against Henrique and Parise. We talked about the aggressive nature of their penalty kill. Downey doesn't capitalize. A little chip play. And then Brett Clark can't handle it. And watch the burst of speed by Parise and Henrique. Can't match pace. It almost looks like the Kovalchuk goal from Parise. 3 points on the night for Parise, and a great job by Henrique, who's on the back end. Watch him put a stick right on the ice, Rick. It's an easy target for the very efficient passer, Zach Parise, to hit. Two shorthanded goals. That's got to hurt.
Well, 3 points for Parise as well as Henrique, who's got a goal and two assists. And how about the unselfish nature of Zach Parise at both those breakaways? He could have easily taken the shot. And Kovalchuk on the first one could have been looking for a rebound as the Lightning continue with a man advantage, 1:21 on the Tillander penalty. But on that play and the plays that set up Henrique.
Well, Rick, I'm so glad you talked about the unselfish nature of this young guy. You see the C on his sweater. It's there for a reason. Not only do the Devils want to keep him long term, obviously, but he is one of the most genuine souls in the National Hockey League. He cares about his teammates, he cares about his organization, he doesn't take shortcuts, and he's a guy that's the ultimate winner. He's an amazing, amazing person.
He and Mark Fain pick up the assists on that shorthanded goal as Le Cavalier with it for Tampa Bay. Now the uphill climb is 3 goals. As Malone stationed around the net, Le Cavalier back out to Bergeron, wristing it, saved by Hedberg as Malone was trying to get a piece of that right from the slot. It's cleared out by Salvador. Well, they missed Parise Pierre for 69 games last year with that knee surgery, and not coincidentally, they missed the playoffs for the first time since 1995.
The whole league missed Zach Parise.
Brewer shooting deflected. Stamkos got a piece of it. Hedberg right there, and he'll hang on to it. You look at the power play scoring by Steven Stamkos. His first year, he really didn't get going till late in that season. But 24 to lead the league the next year, 17 after that, two so far this year. He wins this faceoff. Kabina fires, saved by Hedberg. Kabina had that puck rolling a little bit on him. He had a clear shot at Hedberg, who came out.
We talked about Steven not just being a scorer. He's just a smart player. He wins that draw from young Adam Henrique, and that's right into the wheelhouse for Kabina, who's a heavy shot.
Kabina fires again. Pad saved by Hedberg. Purcell chased to the corner. 30 seconds remaining on this Lightning power play, their third of the game. They've all come in succession. Here's the drive, a save by Hedberg on the try by Hedman. Lightning work to recover it. Purcell behind the net now with Fain moving it. Hedman down the boards against Henrique. Devils clear it down. And Talinder will be back in 5 seconds. With the Devils not only killing the penalty, but adding to their lead with their sixth shorthanded goal of the season. Kabina shoots it in. Dominic Moore getting to it. Pried loose by Eliash. Talinder remaining on for the moment. Zubras swings wide. And Zubras ridden off by Brett Clark. Eliash looking for that puck. Gilroy on the scene as well. Dennis LaRue, the referee down low, urging the players to continue to try to move it. And it finally squirts away to Moore. Angles the pass to Tom Pyatt from the wing. They pass out in front for Thompson. His stick just lifted by the youngster Urbom. And the Devils move it back to center. The shots are 25-16 Tampa Bay. After the Devils open the game out shooting the Lightning 10-2. It's been 23-6 Tampa Bay since then. But it's the Devils who have burst back in front with 3 second period goals for a 5-2 lead.
That third goal given up by Rolson just wasn't good enough by him. They needed him to be better.
Interference called upcoming to the Devils, as we'll get a call against Larson, his second of the period. Tampa Bay trying to get this power play to work. They surrendered a goal on the last opportunity to Henrique. Larson back in the penalty box, Pierre.
The speed of Dana Terrell forces his penalty. Adam Larson can't turn and go with him, so he just rubs him out of the corner. Rob Martel makes the call.
Eliash wins the faceoff, and the Lightning work to come up with it. Stamkos with it in front. Lecavalier shoots. What a save by Hedberg! Sticking out his right skate to Rob Lecavalier, who was looking at that yawning net.
Talinder and Fane, bad rotation down low. Larry Robinson with a little bit of grimace on his face on the New Jersey Devils bench. Both defenders end up on the same side of the ice, so it's bad communication with Zubras. You don't see any defense in there. There's that aggressive stick play by Hedberg. Milbury wanted it after the first period, and he's gotten it twice here in the second. And for Vinny Lecavalier, that's a quality chance gone awry.
Hedberg getting the versus feed in his helmet, apparently. You think, Pierre?
Yeah, I think you're probably right. Mike could have used the versus feed at the draft when Zach Parise was not taken by the Islanders.
Uh-oh. We'll hear about that in the next intermission. 3 minutes to go, so stay tuned. Out comes Lecavalier to center, 1:17 to go on Tampa Bay's fourth power play opportunity. However, the puck turned over, Henrique, and Parise at it again. Parise from the circle, shooting, a save by Garon. Reaches to cover the puck and gets a whistle.
Rick, you've been in this league a long time, and I know you started with the Rochester Americans, but the New Jersey Devils always had an identity. Passive, backwards, Don't force issues. Stay safe. Don't give up odd man rushes. That's the New Jersey Devils in a penalty kill situation. They've already got two shorthanded goals. This is up. Look at how much fun that kid's having playing aggressive hockey. It's awesome to see. Just awesome.
Well, we've talked about the members of that line carrying this team offensively, but in these shorthanded situations with Parise and Henrique together, they've clicked. And Kovalchuk has helped out as well as Carter clears the puck down the ice. 45 seconds remaining on the call against Larson. Tampa Bay frustrated despite the 27-17 shot advantage and a couple of miraculous stops by Hedberg, most notably the one on LeCavalier a moment ago. The Devils have the 5-2 lead. Kabina, and it's taken away by Kovalchuk. Finally, he'll go to the bench in a change. And Kabina lugs that puck to center. Jones is stopped by Fain, and it's worked free by Eliash.
Boy, they miss Marty St. Louis. You can just see it now for the first time in a long time. Hearing boos here in Tampa. I haven't heard that in a long time, Rick.
Well, they're so used to having St. Louis. He had missed a game since November of 2005 until now. There's a centering pass for Thompson, who just tipped it wide as Moore bumped into Hedberg, and the penalty is over. New Jersey back to full strength. And St. Louis is so involved in the game, Pierre. As you know, you work down near the bench all the time. He's always talking, always helping out teammates. That presence just isn't there.
He's a 100-point player who's a leader.
Moore with a shot that's over the net. Shannon, under a minute to go in the second period. Moore with it. His stick was hooked there by Clarkson. Draws a penalty from Moore. A call against Tampa Bay coming up. With 48.9 seconds to go here in the second period, let's head inside the glass with Pierre.
Welcome to the Zach Parise show for the New Jersey Devils. He had a chance to tie the game on Saturday afternoon against the Montreal Canadiens, and Carey Price wasn't able to do it. But tonight, you see that he's just brought another level to this game. Winning races, showing skill, scoring from below the icing line, an effective penalty killer, unselfish, great distribution to Kovalchuk. And then this one, the last goal by the Devils, another shorty onto the stick of Adam Henrique. Zach Parise, superstar personified for the Devils.
New Jersey's second power play chance. They scored with 2 seconds left on their first one on the tip by Zubras. And it's sent out to the circle. Kovalchuk fires back. Eliash shoots, hits the post, chipped across the slot by Parise, and fired down the ice by Hall. This is the first time the Devils have hit 5 goals offensively since a game here on Versus back in November the 16th in Buffalo, and they won 5-3. Pierre, you were on hand for that, weren't you?
I was. They were outstanding in that game, New Jersey. And that's where you could really sense that their forecheck was becoming a weapon. And they're getting more and more comfortable playing that way.
Now the final seconds ticking off here in the second period. And Zach Parise with a big period, a goal and 2 assists. And a last opportunity for New Jersey just off the post by Eliash as their power play will continue into the third. Stay tuned for the Discover Card second intermission with Liam McHugh, Mike Milbury, and Keith Jones. They'll be talking about the Lightning lacking spark and the best American player of all time. Now the Devils in a 2-0 lead. The Lightning answered with 2-2, but in the second period. Goals by the Devils. They've got a 5-2 lead after 40 minutes. Back in downtown Tampa, the St. Pete Times Forum. It's 5-2 Devils to start the third period. Let's head inside the glass with Pierre.
Penalty killing matters so much for the New Jersey Devils. They're number one in the National Hockey League when it comes to penalty killing. Speed, stick positioning, and body positioning when you look at the New Jersey Devils. Structure through the neutral zone, force everything to the outside. Overplay it up high because that's where Tampa Bay is vulnerable. Now you have rotation. Follow up high. Zubrin does a good job. Fain does a good job. Get pucks up and out into the neutral zone. Create speed. Adam Henrique, Zach Parise get a little bit unselfish. A whole lot of technical, and Henrique with the fifth goal, and Zach Parise's having a whale of a night for the New Jersey Devils. They have so much confidence, they're going to play him on a point on a power play.
They continue on their second opportunity of the game with 107 remaining on the penalty to Dominic Moore for tripping. This is a Devil power play that came in three of its last 28, but they capitalized on the first opportunity. Garon handles that one for Brewer. He overskates it. Eric Brewer gets back involved as Eliash retrieves the puck out to Fain. Eliash to Parise. Going to hook up with Kovalchuk, and the Devils are chased back to center. Eliash weaves his way through, had the puck slapped away, and they're forced to center ice once again. Kovalchuk with it. Devils in the goal differential in this period, a minus 16. And when these teams met 3 weeks ago, the Lightning able to get two third period goals to make that game close. They're going to need more than that in this third period, but they'll try to go to work at even strength at about 5 seconds with Clark in the corner. It's punched behind the net. Sikora trying to shake free. Hyatt with it, and he'll bounce it down the ice. Moore does leave the box, so Tampa Bay kills the penalty. The shots in that second period, 17-6 Tampa Bay, but the Devils had all three goals. Bergeron driving it off the glass, and it deflected off Zubris, and the play is whistled down offside. For 36 hours, step inside the life of NHL superstar Patrick Kane. It's the premiere of an all-new series, NHL 36, featuring Patrick Kane Wednesday at 6:30 Eastern, followed by his Blackhawks taking on the Wild here on Versus.
How about Mike Gill and Chuck Fletcher and the job that's being done in Minnesota right now? What a fun team to watch.
Boy, they have just exploded to the top of the Western Conference. Pass out in front for Stamkos off his stick. Gill, the longtime assistant of the Penguins, getting the Wild to buy in. They're getting some healthy defensemen back. They've had a couple of youngsters step up there as well, Pierre, haven't they?
Marco Scandella's been really, really good there for them, playing over 20 minutes a game. He's been solid. Only two other rookie defensemen have played more minutes than Scandella this year.
Downey in front, backhand try, stopped by Hedberg. He'll hang on. Now Malone set to drop him with Clarkson.
Well, David Clarkson's good at this stuff, and he's a little bit smaller than Ryan Malone, so Malone's probably going to try to maul him. Clarkson's got a very quick right hand.
And Malone ducked one punch and tried to answer with a left. And they both got rights free now, and as Malone hits the deck.
You'd be amazed when you meet David Clarkson. He's not an overly large guy, but he's got a whole lot of nasty wire to him. He hurt his hand in that one. Talking to Brad Kovacic right now.
I don't know if he heard it as he was bracing it against the glass there or on the next punch that he hit, seemed to hit Malone in the helmet.
Well, what started this all is David Clarkson on Steve Downing. Stamkos hard on the forecheck, nothing wrong there. Coming in front of the net. You watch right in front of the net, coming right here. Clarkson just puts him down. And Malone doesn't like that because he knows Downey's a target. He's already stepped in once for Downey, and Clarkson goes with Malone. He understands his role, David Clarkson, so is Ryan Malone right now.
Well, they each get fighting majors at 2:01. Second battle of the night as Kabina and Carter went at it early in the second period. As Malone has battled injuries and the lack of having him in this lineup on a steady basis for Guy Boucher has kind of hampered this team this year. Missed a significant amount of time last year, played a lot in the playoffs with an injured shoulder, had surgery on it in the offseason. Lecavalier works it free and out to center ice. And Parise belted by Dominic Moore. The Devils reformulate a rush. Larson, the 19-year-old, taken fourth overall last summer. Long pass to Kovalchuk. Parise skates into his feed, playing it back to Kovalchuk. One touch, the shot, and it's sent over the net by Henrique. I don't know if Garon got a piece of that or not, but what puck move.
Oh, my goodness, that's beautiful hockey to watch. If you're a fan of the Devils, not so pretty if you're the Tampa Bay Lightning.
Kalinder gets the red line, he'll shoot it in. Kabina over for it. Around to Marc-Andre Bergeron. Nearly 3 minutes gone here in the third period. Teddy Purcell picks up the puck. He'll skate it in and test Mark Fain, the Providence College product. Play forced back of the goal. Kabina down the boards. Purcell takes it, slides it in front to Blair Jones. As Zubris got involved to take him down and work the puck free, it's shoveled out. Garon came into this game early in the second period after Dwayne Rollison had allowed the goal by Parise to make it 3-2 Devils. And he stopped only three of the five shots that he faced in relief to finish off the period. Gilroy. Couple of first period assists for the Lightning. The pass is tipped in by Thompson. Hedberg playing it. Ryan Carter, who played for Peter DeBoer for a bit with the Panthers last year. And Carter's travels from the Ducks to the Hurricanes and then on to Florida. And it seems, Pierre, like he might have finally found a home.
Well, he's a New Jersey Devil type of player because he can skate and he's got good size and good hockey sense. Talk about composure. Hedberg to Larson. Instead of going up the wall, boom, Adam Henrique right through the middle. He breaks a forecheck down there. And you want to be a superstar in this league, you pay the price. Zach Parise pays the price. Dominic Moore leans into him. But Zach Parise keeps that play alive for the Devils. There's another example, the unselfish superstar, Parise.
Salvador bounces the puck off the boards to center. It's taken by Bergeron. At center ice, the puck left, Kabina. Came in to take it. It ends up on Kovalchuk's stick. He steps in trying to move around Bergeron, who stays with him, and Pyatt takes over for Tampa Bay.
That's a good play by Marc-Andre Bergeron against Kovalchuk.
Pyatt will tip into the corner. And Talinder there. Devils able to get it out. Here, is this a similar situation for a Henrik Talinder working with a Larson as he did with Tyler Myers in Buffalo?
Very much so.
Henrique now in front to Parise. He's pulled down from behind.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
And Parise,
I think Parise's hurt right here.
Contact
with
the post.
He didn't look very comfortable going into the wall. Dominic Moore and he have collided once before. And you know about the knee situation from last year. A little give and go with Adam Henrique. You see Dominic Moore go piling into him. Not a dirty play in the Toyota RoboCam. You talk about quick counters. Ilya Kovalchuk against Marc-Andre Bergeron. Bergeron plays the man, not the puck. And he takes away a scary scoring situation for the Devils because of responsible defensive play by the undersized Bergeron.
Devils back in the power play with a penalty to Dominic Moore at 4:49. Kovalchuk with it, winding, fires it back. Eliash will set up in the half boards. Sikora down low. Nick Palmieri, the youngster in the slot. Kovalchuk with it. Eliash the one-timer. And a stretching save by Garon.
That's some kind of save by Garon.
At the point, it's Mark Fain. Quick release, and he sends it over the net. Taken by Tyrell. Double-teamed along the board. Stamkos trying to help him out. Brewer shovels it down the ice.
Parise's fine. He's coming back on the ice. Eric Bolton on the power play for the Devils right now. Interesting.
Well, as Fain shoots it in. Hall playing it back of the goal. Clark keeps it up the boards. Thompson after it. He wins the race to tip it down the ice. That call against Moore for tripping. As Clark has it back for Tampa Bay, starts it in. Hedberg leaving it. Hall comes by to take it. Shoots and it's blocked by Henrique. Hall. Going to work it to Pyatt. It ends up on Kovalchuk's stick. Eric Bolton from that left wing side. A shot handled by Garon. He hung on to it long enough with 41 seconds remaining in the power play.
Well, the Devils' power play hasn't been great this year. 26th in the league, but Adam Oates is one happy camper. He runs the power play, and they've added Curtis Foster just before the game tonight. Curtis Foster, a right-handed shooting defenseman, had 8 goals. Playing for Adam Oates and Rick Tocchet a couple years ago in Tampa Bay, and that's going to help this New Jersey power play a ton. Real nice acquisition by Lou Lamoriello, the general manager of the New Jersey Devils.
Both GMs have made additions as Malone released from the box. An equipment problem perhaps at the, he's heading off to the Lightning room, but Antti Miettinen Longtime Dallas star, also with the Minnesota Wild, signed by Steve Yzerman, Lightning general manager. And that was announced earlier today.
Rick, does he not have to go through waivers?
I think he probably would.
Coming from the KHL, he has to go through waivers, so somebody might take him. But I think the fact that Steve Yzerman gave him a two-year contract would probably dissuade some people from trying to pick him up. So that might be the insurance policy, his second year on the contract.
He's had some solid years in the NHL, scoring in the mid-teens. And up around 20 goals earlier in his career with the Stars, when they had a number of Finnish players, with the Yuri Lehtinen in the lineup and Jussi Jokinen and others. Out of the box comes Moore as the penalties expire. Devils maintain control in the Tampa Bay zone. A great glove save by Garon there on the tip by Patrick Eliash. He's left shaking his head, but his Devils lead by three.
It's 5-2, some slick plays. Patrick Eliash, Peter Sikora is going to eventually take a pass and then chip it, and a little up high deflection, a nice glove save, a little give and go from the Czech mates. Eliash and Sikora, the only person missing from the A-line, Jason Arnott, who's had a resurgence in St. Louis. Remember the A-line in 2000 with Larry Robinson coaching? Stanley Cup victors down in Dallas, Texas.
Well, three Stanley Cup championships for this franchise, and Robbie, the head man for one, the late Pat Burns, another one, and obviously Jacques Lemaire, the first one. As the Devils working around that Tampa Bay net, Ryan Shannon gets to the puck, plays it off the boards, not out. Talinder will hold it in, challenged by Shannon, and away comes Le Cavalier. Purcell with it. Le Cavalier looks goal mouth, and it's deflected away by Hedberg, once again using that stick. Larson gets to it. Ryan Carter to center. The Mankato State misses the net, the shot. It's played back by Sikora, and Clark with Carter on him. Fain fires it back in. Gilroy hounded by Zubras. Brewer, long stretch pass for Downey, but too many Devils on the scene. Zubras now enters that zone with Sikora leaving it for him. Back for Zubras, played well by Gilroy. Downey steams ahead for Tampa Bay. His shot is blocked at the defense by Urbom. Centered in front into the slot. Thompson, the turnaround, stolen from behind by Eliash. Try by Tyrell is blocked. Thompson gets to it.
Urbom and Downey have something big time going on down low.
Well, Downey knocked down on top of Hedberg. The puck is loose behind the goal. Tyrell comes up with it, trying to jam it in front. I believe that net is dislodged, but Thompson with it. Now the officials call play, and Downey and Urbom drop the gloves. Urbom 6'4", 215. Downey barely 6 feet and 190.
Urbom's from Sweden, but he played for Brandon Wheat Kings in the Western Hockey League, so he's not foreign to fighting. But Downey just got some leverage on him and put him down.
Well, Rob Martel witnessing our third bout of the night here at 8:23. Urbom, former teammate in Djurgården of the Swedish Elite League, of Victor Hedman of the Lightning. In fact, they're birthdays 2 days apart. They're just set to turn 21.
Here's the battle we were alluding to, Rick. You see Downey and Urbom, nothing wrong there, just jostling for position. And Downey gets pushed right into Hedberg. Urbom doesn't like that, and Downey doesn't like it either. And eventually just the mittens start to fly. It's a yard sale, and you can see the size differential there. Downey with some leverage gets down low underneath at one point, just puts Urbom down with a wrestling move.
Extra penalty to Urbom for the cross check, so Tampa Bay comes out of this with a power play chance. Zach Parise talking it over with Dennis LaRue. The NHL on Versus continues tomorrow at 8 Eastern. The Sharks take on the Abs. Then on Wednesday, it's the Blackhawks and Wild following the premiere of NHL 36, Patrick Kane. Hockey is here on Versus. You get to see Patrick Kane behind the scenes and then see him on the ice against the Minnesota Wild. And what a game that should be, with the Wild playing as well as they have been, and the Hawks right behind him, 3 points behind them, with 40 in second place in the Western Conference.
Patrick Kane scored a Stanley Cup winning goal in Game 6 in Philadelphia a couple seasons ago. He's the only guy in the building that knew it was in, Rick.
That was an odd one, wasn't it? But it ended all those years of frustration for Hawks fans. That shot by Bergeron missed the target. Power play chance number 5 for Tampa Bay. Puck deflected down the ice by Henrique. And Bergeron with it. Bergeron brought on last year like Rolison. He was coming off a serious knee surgery and joined the team in early February. Puck cleared down the ice by Parise.
There was also some insider trading on that. They were very familiar with him because he played Hamilton in the American League for Boucher. Good chance for LeCavi, who was swatted away by Salvador.
Salvador, a match for him in terms of size, leaning in on him as he approached the net. Guerin back for the puck.
Look out.
And Eliash steals it. Walks in. He's got Zubris with him. Lets it go to Brewer, out for LeCavalier. Just over a minute left in that extra penalty. Sestito is serving it for the youngster Urban. Loose puck, side of the goal. Stamkos in front, shoots. He scores! Steven Stamkos' first shot of the night ends up with the net. Tampa Bay down 2 with 10.5 to play.
Steven Stamkos doesn't need a lot of chances. And this one's about as glorious as it's going to get for Stamkos. Teremina does a good job on Moore. You see the Devils have everything locked up with Eliash fans on, and a nice play by Moore, not quitting on the play, putting it out front. Watch 19 in blue. He doesn't quit on the play. Keep battling, then he comes in, puts it right onto the stick of Stamkos, who finishes it off. Again, the fundamentals of a goal score. Find a dead spot in coverage, support on the forecheck, put your stick down, give a target, and then roof it. That is beautiful hockey by Dominic Moore and Steven Stamkos.
Well, Stamkos really had it going in recent weeks, scoring 5 goals in 4 consecutive games. Here's Parise shooting, and it's deflected wide. That streak finally ended, and he had gone 5 without a goal coming into tonight's game. Now picks up his 17th. One off the lead. The pace is set by Milan Mikolic and Phil Kessel at 18 goals apiece. Here's Talinder shooting, and it's deflected wide by Hall. He's checking out his hockey stick to make sure it's still in one piece, heads for the bench as the Devils pressured here by Blair Jones, one of the Tampa Bay goal scorers in this game. Puck shot in by Bolton, it's off the glass support, comes down to Hedman. Long pass ahead for Jones. Joined on the rush by Purcell and Shannon. Salvador looks for Carter on the boards. Puck deflected back to Pyatt. He is knocked down by Eric Bolton. And Pyatt gets the puck back again, but he's got a teammate trapped in that zone offside. Carter back the other way for the Devils. Ryan Carter, who had a goal and an assist in the Devils' earlier win in this building, November the 19th, slides the puck to Zubris. Moore and LeCavalier pick up the assists on the Stamkos power play goal, his 17th overall and 3rd with a man advantage.
Rick, you have to love the way Dominic Moore didn't quit on that forecheck play. He battled through the amazing New Jersey Devil players to set the puck up for Stamkos. It's a real character play by Dominic Moore, who's playing fantastic hockey for Tampa.
Loose pocket, it's fired on goal by Pyatt. He got it loose from the skates of Henrik Delander and tested Hedberg, and the Devils move it out. Moore's one of the veterans on this team that is counted on for leadership, and obviously in the absence of Marty St. Louis until after Christmas, apparently, from what we're told, because of those facial fractures, he's expected to step it up. Has been doing so the last couple of games, really starting with the first game that St. Louis missed with the comeback and his shorthanded goal against the Rangers, and then the game decider in overtime. Brewer hands it now to Stamkos. Goes through one check by another Devil. Takes on Talinder, forced wide. Henrik with a long reach at 6-4. Stamkos still in the puck. Moore with him. Kabina joining the play down low. It's centered in front. Thompson shoots. Save! Hedberg! He hangs on. Now Stamkos gets going. Adam Henrique steps in there. More feisty action in front of the Devil net.
We talked about Parise and the unselfish nature of his game. How about Steven Stamkos? A burst of speed in the neutral zone. creates an unbelievable chance for Nate Thompson. More Thompson and the glove from the Big Moose.
Along with Pierre McGuire, Rick Peckham with you. The Devils in front 5-3 with just under 8 minutes to go in his third period. And Steven Stamkos igniting his team on the comeback trail. Bergeron trying to send in Victor Hedman, who saw an opening between the Devil defense. Getting to the puck, it's Nate Thompson. Lena Tyrell works it free. Pierre with that media timeout. Guy Boucher coming right back with that unit.
He should. They've been working hard all game long, playing with energy and some pace.
Little added bonus for coaches these days, having those media timeouts to help you, huh?
They are. Definitely.
Bergeron turns the net. Tampa Bay has a 32-21 shot advantage in this game. We told you 17-6 in the second period. Didn't do much good. The Devils scored on three of their six shots. Puck is played by Sikora, getting to it. Clarkson fires in front. Eliash will take it off the boards and shoot. Missed the net. Clarkson met there by Brewer. From the point, Salvador off the glass support. And Garon reaching around, just poked that puck away. Eliash works away from Brewer. Clarkson takes it, swings in front. Salvador waiting at the blue line. Out of the reach of Sikora. Still a pretty lengthy session for New Jersey in the Tampa Bay zone.
Smart pinch by Larson because Elias was back supporting him. A really good read by young Larson.
Clarkson had it work free. Brewer has it. Here, as we were saying earlier in the game, that previous meeting where the Lightning were trying to come back, it was a shift kind of like that, different line. It was the fourth line, but that really kind of quelled the uprising. It'll be interesting to see from here the effect it has on this game.
Good momentum pushback by the line of Eliash, Clarkson, and Sikora. You can see them talking on the bench. A lot of it's because of Adam Larson and a really good pinch. Puck's going to come around the boards, but it's great pursuit by all the Devils players to keep plays alive and keep plays in deep and grind on the Tampa defense.
Parise sends it in. Clark back. Leaves it for Gilroy. Slips it to Blair Jones. Puck taken back by Termina on the defense, looking for Parise at the line, matched up with Gilroy. Jones for the Lightning. Teddy Purcell off the glass through center, taken by Adam Henrique. Termina from center drives it in. Jones getting to it. Pounded there by Kovalchuk. Brent Clark swerves away from the forecheck. 5.5 to go in the third. As Purcell turned it over, Lightning had peeled back at a change. And Victor Hedman near the bench absorbs a hit to get it to Thompson. He'll dump it in from center ice. Salvador pressured by Thompson. High it in for the puck. They work with Downey. Downey with it. Downey turns, fires it front, deflected wide by Thompson. Devils moving out as Carter went down. He was able to get it ahead to Bolton. And Hedman back, chased by Zubris. The play is ruled offside. 5:03 to go, third period. Devils leading 5-3. Welcome back to the Channelside District in downtown Tampa. We're at the newly renovated St. Pete Times Forum, where the Devils led 2-0, surrendered that lead, moved in front 5-2. The Lightning have scored here in the third. As Moore fires in front, it's off Hedberg. Puck lifted out by Sikora. Clarkson slides into the corner. Bergeron back. Helped out by Stamkos. Devils played at center. LeCavalier tapped it free for Moore. Bryce Salvador, who was actually a sixth-round pick of the Lightning back in 1994, never signed with a team, played most of his career with the Blues. Eliash playing it back. They couldn't clear the shot on goal. Garon the save on Sikora. And away comes Stamkos. He works with LeCavalier and Moore. Stamkos closing and shooting. Hedberg the save. Rebound is cleared away by Parise. Hedman fires in front and he sends it wide. Le Cavalier was looking for the tip. Hedman fires it across, couldn't get it through Parise. In fact, did that hit him, Pierre, up high?
It did. He'll shake it off. Got him in the thumb.
He tried to reach up and glove it. Puck loose at the Lightning net. They get it free to Ryan Malone. He'll play it out. All the penalty boxes have cleared from all the combatants.
Short bench for the Devils on defense. You don't see a lot of Urbom right now.
Leaner back, Lightning back on side. 3.5 to play in the third. Puck sent down the ice. And this will be an icing call if Gilroy gets there, and he does.
You see Parise trying to shake off the after effects of that puck hitting him in the hand. Le Cavalier, a little cross and drop with Stamkos. Lightning quick release, juicy rebound. Guess who's back? 9 and white, Zach Parise. It's a well set up play by Le Cavalier. You get people going in the net like that. Great back check by Zach Parise. Timeout. Jersey. A little bit of fatigue. Off the icing.
Now it's Parise trying to gather himself again. Peter DeBoer with Larry Robinson leaning over, designing what they want to do off this faceoff of the defensive zone as far as Tampa Bay is concerned. Obviously, they miss Marty St. Louis in a lot of situations, but Pierre, this is where they would have him with Le Cavalier and Stamkos in one of those eggs in one basket line for Guy Boucher, but he's not available. Dominic Moore is stepping in there. Stamkos comes down, out of that huddle.
Down, he's yelling at David Clarkson. I have no idea why. But he's just ripping into David Clarkson. I guess Clarkson can have that effect on you, but it's one heck of a useful player.
Couple of disturbers.
Yes.
Carter against Stamkos in the faceoff, and the Devils end up with it. Larson ahead to Sikora. He'll tap it in. And we'll get an icing call here against the Devils once again.
Well, Rick, you were talking about Adam Larson, fourth overall in the 2011 draft. Played for Skellefteå, which was one of the top teams in the Swedish series last year. He plays 22-21 on average. Jake Gardner for Toronto's number two for rookies at 20-37. And Marco Scandella's 20-22. So Larson playing more minutes on average than any other rookie in the NHL.
Devils come up with a puck. Sikora plays it in behind the defense as Bergeron back for it. Fires it off the stick of Stamkos, rolls to Hedberg. He'll play it away to the corner. And it's lifted down the ice by Larson. That puck draws back, and so the Lightning get to it. There's no icing. Tampa Bay trying to complete a change. You get Le Cavalier ahead of the pack. Clarkson has it. Couldn't step inside on Bergeron. Fires it ahead for Le Cavalier over his stick. Hedberg, anxious to play it, settles for covering.
I'm not sure Johan Hedberg wants to be handling these pucks too much more, Rick.
Yeah, he thought about it there and then thought better of it. Stay tuned for the Bud Light postgame show with Liam McHugh, Mike Milbury, and Keith Jones coming up. After the game, we'll be talking about the coaching change in L.A. with John Stevens taking over and the U.S. Hockey Hall of Fame ceremonies tonight in Chicago. Puck bounced down the ice by Salvador. And they rule no icing. The Lightning bring it back up ice. Salvador out fights Moore with it. Moore leaving it in the corner.
Look where Ilya Kovalchuk was on the back check. He's all the way down deep in the defensive corner. You wouldn't have seen that from him a couple years ago. Not a chance.
Peter DeBoer and his staff doing some serious selling. Get him in that position.
You got that right. He's probably through guilt watching Parise and he's saying, I got to be like that guy.
Henrique occupies a pair of Lightning players with under 2 minutes to go in the third. And in the meantime, keeping Matthew Guerin in goal. Of course, with a two-goal deficit, we'll see if and when Tampa Bay can get him off the ice. Hedman As the Lightning are changing, he's buying a little time. Bergeron works with him.
Rick, who gets a start for Tampa in their next game against Calgary here in Tampa?
Well, Garon has played pretty solidly. And so it'll be interesting to see, certainly, but he's made a case for himself. A couple of goals in the second period, but it will be interesting to see what the decision is from Guy Boucher with Rolison and Garon, as Garon now reaching the bench with 1:21 to go in regulation time, and his team down by two.
Not making excuses again for the Tampa Bay Lightning. They're going to call a timeout right now. But without Marty St. Louis, they're missing a major component that helps them win. It's a gigantic loss for this Lightning team.
Well, Steven Stamkos at the fulcrum of that huddle, working with Boucher. As Tampa Bay, as we mentioned earlier, had won six straight here in their home ice, but trailing in this one, and they had lost three out of four coming in. And as they start play tonight in 13th spot in the Eastern Conference standings, 26 points, three behind the Devils. And as we said right off the hop here, this is getting to a point where, yes, it is around the 30-game mark for both teams, but when you've got four and five teams to climb over and you're 4 and 5 points out of a pack that we know is pretty evenly distributed, got to get things going.
Once you get to the All-Star break, if you're double-digit points out, your chances of making the playoffs are slim and none. So you better not be double-digit points out by the All-Star break. The All-Star game going to be in Ottawa this year, a spectacular venue for the All-Star game.
Well, Le Cavalier set to go in against Carter on this faceoff, and it rolls in front. Parise with it. He'll ease it off the glass. And Bergeron trying to hammer it back in. Kovalchuk got a stick in the way. Carter, Kovalchuk, Parise up front for the Devils here, facing an empty net. Stamkos takes control for Tampa Bay. Just about a minute to go in the third. Pass to Kabina. Launches one to the corner. Larson seeing action in this critical moment. The 19-year-old helping the Devils clear it out. Le Cavalier skims it off the glass. Around for Downey. One of the Lightning goal scorers in this game. Chopped loose by Malone, gets it in front, trying to hook it on goal, stopped there. Le Cavalier recovers it. Kabina sends it across. Stamkos shoots, he scores! 33.5 to play in the third. The Lightning have closed to within one. It's 5-4.
Larry Robinson furious on the New Jersey Devil bench. You think you have everything contained. They're furious at the official, too. They think there should be a penalty. Watch the takedown coming up. Down goes Elias. They don't have enough bodies in defensive posture. Cross box feed, and then the one-timer for the heavy shooting Stamkos. He's not going to make a mistake there. That's a big miss. 33 seconds to go. Tampa's still in this thing because of Stamkos.
His second goal of the night, both here in the third period. He scored for Moore and Le Cavalier in a power play earlier. And Garon, for the moment, back in net for Tampa Bay. Stamkos now at 18 goals, tied for the league lead in goal scoring. They're going to need another one here if they want to keep this game going as the Devils send the Lightning back. Garon now getting to the bench for the extra skater. And it's Downey coming off as it's played by Fain up the glass. Bouncing down and flipped to center by Eliash. Pavel Kabina there, driving it back to Le Cavalier at the line. Picked up by Salvador, 6 seconds to go. Stamkos along the boards, occupied by two Devils. Malone in the corner, he's kept there. And that was a safe place for the Devils to force the puck along the boards, and they close out a 5-4 victory as they pick up their third win in the last 8 games. And Johan Hedberg has been a steady presence in the net. And he faced 36 shots in this contest with 32 saves, supported by Sikora and Zubras to open up the scoring for 2-0. Tampa Bay came back, Downey and Jones scoring a minute 20 apart to tie. In the second, Parise took over, a goal and two assists as Kovalchuk and Henrique also scored to make it 5-2. And Stamkos certainly makes it interesting with a couple of goals to give him 18 on the season. 5-4 is the final. Let's join Pierre downstairs.
Thanks a lot, Rick. Zach, you had total control of that game. You let it go at the tail end of the first period here at the tail end of the third. What happened?
Well, that's kind of been our problem. We've had leads. We're just not doing a good job of protecting them. We're going to have to address that and see what we're doing differently. I mean, they got a 6-on-5. They got pretty good players. They're going to make plays, but we got to be in better position.
Tell us about the chemistry on your line with Henrique and Kovalchuk. You guys were lighting it up, not only 5-on-5, but shorthanded as well.
Well, it's like I told you before, the game, it's been getting better. We started off a little slow together, but the last 10 games or so, we're finding each other all over. We're having fun, and I think that's the biggest difference.
What's the biggest difference in what Peter Boer's done with systems here with your team?
Just much more aggressive, and I think that's allowing us to get more offense. That's allowing us to get some more scoring chances. But I think Pete's preaching not to give as much up defensively, and I think that's a spot that we can be a little better at.
What's the one thing, if you were Lou Lamoriello right now, to help your power play? You went out and got Curtis Foster. Do you need anything else?
Well, I think with him, from what I hear, he's got a pretty nice shot from the point, and I think that's something that we could really use. I think if you have a good shot from the point, it's going to open up Patty, it's going to open up Kobe, and something should be open.
There are a lot of people that know you have a relationship with Travis Zajac going back to the University of North Dakota. When do you think we'll see Travis Zajac back?
I don't know. Rumor has it possibly soon. He's been practicing with us. He looks really good. I think he's going to be ready before everyone thinks.
Thanks for your time, and I hope you're feeling all right.
Feel great. Thank you.
Thanks, Zach. Rick?
Pierre, thanks very much. Zach Parise in the middle of that pivotal second period with a goal and two assists. 5-4 Devils, the final score. Coming up next, we'll check in with the Bud Light postgame show and then on to NHL overtime. Thanks for watching tonight for the St. Pete Times Forum as the